Cooper is in this amazing period of growth. And to be part of a venture like that is an exciting thing by itself.
Cooper is the only level one trauma center in South Jersey, also the only comprehensive stroke center. And as such, we see the sickest of the sick patients.
The breadth and the variety of cases and the complexity of cases we see here is unparalleled to many other programs in the country.
This hospital system is in a huge stage of growth. Their net of care is so large, right? Ranging from here in Camden all the way out to the Southern Jersey Shore, Cape May.
We have been the highest level of care in Southern New Jersey. There's no question that there's been a quantum leap along the trend of growing neurosurgery at Cooper.
We are now up to 10 faculty in neurosurgery. All kinds of subspecialties in neurosurgery are very well represented. What we have is an opportunity for residents to work with some of the most accomplished neurosurgeons of this current generation.
If you look at our faculty group, all of us are trained at different programs and did fellowships at different programs, so that's a big advantage for all our residents.
I'm the director of the Cooper Spine Program, which includes orthopedics and neurosurgery spine, as well as PM&R and pain management.
My goal would be to establish a minimally invasive spine surgery program where we will be doing all state-of-the-art minimally invasive spine surgery.
We have the MD Anderson Cancer Center here, and that has become one of the best cancer centers in this region.
We have a multidisciplinary approach to every patient who comes here for their brain tumor treatment.
We have the ability to do stereotactic surgery through minimally invasive approaches, neuroendoscopic approaches, with small little tubes you could take a tumor out. We have the gamma knife, which basically you could target non-invasively tumors that are deep within the brain.
Our residents get exposure to all type of brain tumor cases and skull-based cases, including open skull-based techniques, as well as expanded endonasal approaches.
They get to work with me directly in the operating room to do very complex cerebrovascular cases, including cerebral bypass, EC to IC bypasses, venous malformation resections, complex aneurysm reconstructions, and the whole gamut of cerebrovascular neurosurgery.
My goal is to build both a comprehensive and modern functional neurosurgery program here at Cooper. I think it's important to learn the traditional ways of doing things, but also to then incorporate these emerging technologies into the practice.
There's no technology that is currently used in neurosurgery that we're missing in Cooper.
Some of the technology that we have is robotics. That is a new big thing that we see in spine.
These are things that aren't available at every facility, and the ability to be at a place like Cooper and be exposed to that, learn about those new technologies, and be a part of it is what is so important.
Cooper Neurosurgery Residency is not a new residency. We've been training neurosurgery residents here for 20 years.
There's an apprentice-like teaching model here where we get to, as faculty, we get hands-on direct work with residents, including at a junior level.
You know, in general, much of it is akin to a parent and a child in terms of trying to teach them the right way to do things.
Our attendants have made it a priority to have our relationships be friendly and also being professional.
Something that I was blown away by after my interview at Cooper was just how strong the culture was here. Right when I closed my computer, I went down to my girlfriend. I said, wow, everybody there was really pleasant to talk to. I really enjoyed that interview day.
One of the best parts and things that have made me feel so welcome here is that we have a great relationship with the other residents throughout the hospital. It just seems like a fantastic community to grow and learn here.
I think what really sets the Cooper Neurosurgery Residency Program apart is the ability of our residents and faculty to work together as a team. We're a close-knit group of people that really look out for one another.
As the rising chief, I'm really excited to get to work with all the junior residents and get to mentor them. We really try to treat each other as a family here.
The culture of the program here is the biggest strength of the program. When I interviewed here first for a faculty position, the first thing I was told was, we take care of each other. And that still holds true, and that really is the essence of this program.
It's a culture that the residents work in. They see it from the top down, where the attendings are nice to each other, they take care of each other. That sense of teamwork is palpable in our residency.
I think one of my biggest things coming in was that I think I want to do skull base. I started talking to our skull base neurosurgeon here, Dr. Goodale, and she was able to really provide, you know, some mentorship in regards to what research projects I should be getting involved with, what cases I should be looking into and reading more about. No matter what you want to do, our attendants are always available to give you time to talk to them.
As the associate program director of the residency program, it's a huge responsibility on our shoulders to train the leaders of future neurosurgery. We've created a mentorship program where it's one-to-one mentorship from faculty to residents, and we really sit down with them at the beginning of their residency and talk about what their goals are for 7 years. And then their seven-year experience is really geared towards helping them achieve those goals.
So when our residents graduate this program, they are absolutely prepared and confident that they'll be able to handle any neurosurgical emergency that comes their way. I mean, that's going to be easy for them.
To come into my chief year, I feel confident in, you know, making these surgical decisions and starting to take care of these patients like they're my own.
So I think Cooper can really offer you a really well-defined and comprehensive training within neurosurgery.
Neurosurgery is a very demanding field, and our goal is to make it as enjoyable and easy for you as possible. A big focus of our program is resident well-being and wellness.
Dr. Yoakum has huge derby parties every year, so there's always time to interact with all of our attendings, and our attendings are our friends in addition to our bosses. So
it's a program that provides you not just with excellent clinical training, it really is a program where residents can flourish together as a family.
In lots of the events that we have outside of Cooper, whether it's graduation type events or weddings, almost all the attendings are there. It's a relationship that we build with them that starts in the hospital, but that extends even beyond the hospital. It's like we're almost a huge, huge family.
This is a place where you can come and you can express yourself in whatever way you want. And this program will be accepting of that and will adapt around you to let you learn in the best way possible for you. One of the big things that Cooper is working towards is getting us involved with more and more research early on. The second I was brought in for my orientation date, I was already having meetings set up with some of these top researchers here at the hospital.
My goal this year was to try to get as much papers done as possible, and I was able to get about 6 publications in, but this wouldn't have been possible without some of the help that some of our faculties and our core residents also give us.
Here we are just very focused on you as a resident. We want to make this the best training program for you.
Over the years, it's common for me to have a junior resident, and I'll go to the program director and say, I can't train this person. And his response every time was the same, fix them. So far, that's been successful. It's a supportive environment with a commitment to turn you into a neurosurgeon.
Juggling fatherhood and residency is tough. It's hard not to bring home a lot of kind of what we see. But nothing kind of brightens your day more than being able to come home and see him.
Philly is a really dynamic city that has all the advantages of a major East Coast city. So one thing I was really pleasantly surprised by was the food scene. There are tons of really good restaurants around.
I moved to South Jersey and to Cooper University Hospital in part because my family liked the area. We like the outdoors things to do here. There's a wonderful atmosphere, sports-focused atmosphere here.
The culture of the city itself, right? It's not as rough as New York. It's not as, you know, lackadaisical as the West Coast. It's a perfect balance.
I think the future of neurosurgery at Cooper is very bright, and it's a great opportunity for residents to be here.
Cooper Neurosurgery Residency Program is a hidden gem in this country. The collegiality and camaraderie that we provide at Cooper is unbeatable.
Neurosurgery is an extremely challenging discipline. It's one with the highest of highs and the lowest of lows, and you're going to need a team by your side, and that's the kind of thing that we at Cooper can provide.
It's just a place of growth, and that's a place you want to be in.
There are very few opportunities like this in the United States, and I felt that if you assemble the right group of people here, you can do magic. And that's what we have here. We have the right group of people now to do this work.